All right, listen up. You people will not die on me in combat. You fucking new guys who do everything to prove me wrong. You walk on trails, kick cans, sleep on guard, smoke dope, and diddly bop through the bush like you were back on the block. Wearing guard at night, you write letters, play with your organ, and think of your girl back home. Forget her. Some hairhead has her on her back right now and is telling her to fuck for peace. This is Han. Those of you who are foolish will think of him as Goop, Slope, Slant, or Dink. He is your enemy. He came over on the Chew Hoy program, and he'll go back out there after he fattens up on sea rations, and he will be hunting your young asses in the Ye Shao Valley. Now forget about this Viet Cong shit. What you encounter out there is hardcore NVA, North Vietnamese, motivated, highly trained, and well-equipped. If you meet Han or his cousins, you will give him respect and refer to those little bastards as Nathaniel Victor. Meet him twice and survive, you will call him Mr. Nathaniel Victor. People, I am tired of filling body bags with your dumb fucking mistakes. You think this funny? Alphabet?
Languilli.
Han is closing in on your position. It's night. Look at me! I'm gonna save your life and you're gonna save mine. It's night. It's raining. While you're thinking about peace, love, and whether or not we should be in Vietnam, Han is gonna cut your fucking throat. And you're sleeping.
No, Sergeant.
You've been humping to boonies for months. You're tired. It's your turn to sleep. You're allowed to sleep. What do you think Han is gonna do? Is he gonna wake up Alphabet and smile? And talk about women? Mr. Nathaniel Victor gets his rocks off watching you die. Now, some of you think you have problems because you're against the war. You demonstrated in school, you wear peace symbols on your steel, and you have attitudes. I'm an orphan. My brother's queer. The city of Chicago got the clap from my sister. Mom drinks, dad coughs blood. I have ringworm, immersion foot, the incurable crud, and the draft ruined my chances of being a brain surgeon. People, you have no problem. Except me. And him.